following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do a great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for
that's awesome.
For a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Always do your best, but don't overdo. When you overdo, you deplete your body and go against yourself, and it will take longer to accomplish your goal. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 41, NASDAQ down 12, S&P's up 6. Market bottom line shook off that red coming into this morning, folks, and this market wants higher price. I expect what we're going to see, we're going to continue to see a contraction of volume as we get higher. If we take a look at this S&P futures, what you had out here today is that we get up to 2684. The high of yesterday was 2674. It looks to me at this particular point that we are also going to have lighter volume. Taking a look at this future market also, no reason we can't bounce all the way somewhere up to like the 2771 area. That's quite a while away. That's like a couple, 27. Yeah, it's 100 points from where we are. Gold contract, they're hitting a gold contract out here today. It's down $9.60, 12.12 an ounce. Now, they are hitting this with volume, too. So this is going to get, really interesting watching how it comes in to the last swing area. And this is what you have. So your sign of strength was a monster. And the sign of strength is 532,000 contracts. That's when we went on October 11th. We went from a price point of 1194 to 1230. We came back down and we tested that area with 249,000 contracts. Now, we came off the area with 278. You can see what's happening here. We've done 280. So that's a big number on the way down, no doubt. Bottom line, I suspect what you're going to have here is that we're going to go down to the bottom of this consolidation and go after the 1196 once again. If we look at this intraday, and we see how this is set up intraday, what you do have is that the volume died after 1217. So the last $5 doesn't have the juice that it had going down to 1217. That in itself is not bullish, not bearish, but it sets up a test of those lows, and we'll find out if they got enough juice to blow those lows away. I don't think they do at this particular point. Silver, we go to the silver contract. We take a look at silver. What you have with silver is this. Silver's down with 39,000 contracts. And that's also an expansion of volume. You know, bottom line is that yesterday it started coming down with 44,000. We did 39 today. It looks game is on here for silver to actually go touch its low of $13.98. And we go over to King Dollar. Now, here we go. So, King Dollar is higher. Not dramatically higher. Doesn't have the volume, but bottom line is it's still holding price. King Dollar looks like it's going to go after the swing high that was established out here on the 12th of November. That number is 97530. Notes and bonds. Well, let's go to the TLT first. You're going to see it's right across all the stages here. TLT right now, yesterday we did 6.5 million shares. Good number. Today, you're at 4.4, nothing huge. Notes and bonds, different ball game, meaning specifically the note and bond market folks want higher price. And what's going to be wild here is watching how this thing shakes out because of the fact that what we have is that you're talking about monster volume coming in both of these structures. Over the October 26th swing high, that swing high on the 10-year is 119.06. It's done 2.8 million contracts. That is one big, big number, folks. If we go take a look at the 30-year, same type of setup in the 30-year. You're talking about big numbers in the 30-year. 30-year has done 664,000 contracts. So you have the marketplace, the larger players inside the marketplace. They are buying notes and they're buying bonds, and they're doing it pretty intensely. The 10-year yield, we're edging closer and closer to the 3.30 number. We're at 3.05 right now, and that's come down from 3.23. So you're talking about big numbers out here. Some of the higher volume equities out here, this is what we're looking at. You get Advanced Micro is up 97 cents. General Electric still in big trouble. That's down 10 cents. You get Apple down $1.49. Apple can't get out of its way. Ford Motor Company's off 12 cents. You get Microsoft up 51. And I believe that what that will do, let's go take a look at that. But I believe what's going to happen now is that Microsoft's going to be a larger market cap than Apple. So Microsoft is $826 billion. Apple, they've been fighting it out as the largest company, $821. So Microsoft just took over Apple as the highest market cap in U.S. markets. Big number. Some of the other high volume equities out here today, we have Oracle is down $1.11. You have General Motors is down $1.30. The GM deal, bottom line, it breaks higher yesterday, has volume behind the move, as they say they're going to get rid of 14,000 jobs. Then intraday out here, you had Trump saying that he might try to basically take away the subsidies in the electric cars for the plant closings in Ohio, Michigan, Maryland. We'll see where it shakes out. Bottom line is that when you take a look at this setup, technically it's an ABC structure on the way up. Your A point on this is $30.89. Your B is 37. So we're talking, we're talking about $6.50, which will get you up to approximately the $40 level. That's how this baby is setting up right now. Google, we've got to take a look at Google out here. Google is trading at a price point of 1042.97. You want to keep your eye on Google. The reason being, folks, is that what we have is this, is that Google has tested the February high volume low twice. Last time it tested it, it had much lighter volume than the test prior to it, which sets up higher price than what Google did have. Is that you had buyers in Google yesterday, and it's subtle, but the bottom line is that we had an expansion of volume. And any type of expansion of volume that you actually see in equities right now, that is really positive, because the indices, they're all going up on light volume. I expect they will. But what you can glean out of that, if in fact Google is gonna basically be good, then that's gonna set up that we actually are gonna be in a monster consolidation, a 4,000 point consolidation inside the Dow Industrials, a 400 point consolidation inside the S&P. Come right back. Hi folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 56. You get the NASDAQ down 12. S&Ps are up 7. And so let's check this out. 9 million fewer Americans, folks, shopped this Black Friday weekend. The total holiday shopping this year might not be one for the record books, but you wouldn't know it by looking at the past weekend's numbers. More than 165 million Americans shopped either in stores or online during the five-day period from Thanksgiving through Cyber Monday, more than expected, but well below the 174 million shoppers during that same period last year, according to the National Retail Federation. Average shopper spent $313 over the period, down from last year's $335. The lowest spending for Thanksgiving and days immediately following isn't a sign of poor retail demand. Instead, highlights more shoppers are starting to spend early as retailers pull promotions forward. Walmart, Best Buy, Target are among the big retailers that unveiled holiday deals in early November to grab the early shoppers and grab their bread. Which, you know, it's so intriguing. I didn't shop at all. And this whole deal, I get a feeling, what it seems like, folks, is that, you know, the deals are out there for longer periods of time. So before, yeah, Black Friday used to be the big deal, Cyber Monday was the deal, but guess what? It seems like you can get a deal just about every day out there. That's how this thing seems to be shaking out. We get over and we take a look at the, so we're talking about Google. Google's important to watch, folks, in the aspect of if they can get traction on the way up. The XLE and the XLF, those two babies are the ones you want to keep an eye on. XLE just can't get any traction whatsoever, and we're at $64.65. Number that you want to keep your eye on there is, let's see, February, yeah, 60. That's 08, wow, okay, 1 second. That went quick. I put that back 15 years, okay. So, yeah, the number you want to keep your eye on here is $64.45. You know, it's got to make it back inside that area, because if it doesn't, that is saying your probability gets much higher that, number one, you know, this high volume low inside the S&P, bottom line, not only going to get hit, we won't be able to get above it. And the XLF, you're talking about $26.76, and we are at $26.48 right now. If we do go inside the Dow Industrials and we take a look at the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow, the strength out here is Verizon. That's up 2.2%. Walgreens Boots is up 2%. You get Home Depot up 1.8%, and you get United Health up 1.3%. Taken away from it, they're going to break up. United Technologies, market, that's down 4.5%. You get DuPont off 1%. Nike is down 1. Let's go over and take a look at Verizon and see what's putting some juice in Verizon right here. So the low for the year is 46. The high is 61. They pay a 3.9% dividend at this price. Look at this thing, man. This just wants higher price. Yeah. Put this back. Let's put it back 15 years. Whoa. You get action here, man. This is a... Okay, 20 years. Let me see. 30 years. Okay, so yeah, it's going for its high. So Verizon's high is $62.29. And thus far, we have got into, let's see, 61.58. It's quite a feat. 2008, you're down to 21 bucks. You know, so you get price appreciation of 300%, 200% rather, plus a dividend that's paying almost 5% a year. 4% a year, 3.98 right now. We're going to take a look at the king dog out here when we talk about shopping, Amazon. Amazon right now, sideways market out here today, and Amazon's going to be a classic. You know, Amazon's not done on the way down yet. You know, you get a high volume low on Amazon on the 20th of November. You come off that, had volume yesterday of 6.2 million. We have a contraction of volume out here today. You know, Amazon looks to me like you can actually get up to about 1685. So it's a decent run that it can make topside. That being said, when you actually do pull this back, you're going to see that you know, this came off the highs with some real volume. I think lower prices are coming at us. That's the way that Amazon seems to be setting up right now. We got to take a look at the XAU, the HUI. So this will be intriguing to see what kind of volume that we get on the way down in the XAU and the HUI. Now, I don't get that volume till 8 o'clock at night in the XAU and the HUI. What we had out here, let's go look at we get yesterday's, though. Yeah, so yesterday you did 22 million, and you're going against 44, so that's not bad. So we are going against big volume inside the XAU as well as the HUI. We're going against 44 million. And I'll pull a few more of these gold equities up to see whether we even get close to something like that. Okay, so. And the gold bugs contract. We did 17 million yesterday, and you're going against 33. So let's go take a look at some of the higher weighted structures. So you get ABX, that's coming down 33 cents. That doesn't have big volume. It's got 12 million. Newmont, yeah, this is that volume. You get 3 million. Royal Gold, these are the largest weighting structures inside the GDX also. Royal Gold's down 250. That's got 244,000. That's still going against 505. Franco-Nevada, FNV. That's 320,000, and you're coming against 520. So when you take a look at the actual equities, so the contract is coming down on volume. When you take a look at the actual equities, it's not coming down on volume. Let's go to the GLD, take a look at that. So the GLD is down 6.1 million, but yet you're going into 13.5. Yeah, you're going to need a lot more to break down. That's the bottom line. Yeah, so that's pretty cool. Small caps, we take a look at the small caps out here, the IWM. So the IWM out here. Down $1.40, we're at 148.40. That also is back on light volume. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday at 20 past the first hour. Don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show here every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter. That newsletter, you can come over to our website at TFNN. Right, you're going to see right on the front page, you're going to go to newsletters. You'll see the opening call right there. And I apologize to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, because as I'm running through that whole thing, man, I didn't realize you were right there, Basil. What's happening, brother?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing great, man. How you doing?
It was good listening to you going through all those different things. Those are important aspects, especially the look at Amazon.
Yeah. Well, not as important of what Basil's going to be doing, folks, okay? And our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, you know, he's got a great newsletter. but he's also going to be doing a webinar. And this is going to be a two-part webinar series. You know, it's coming up. This two-part webinar series is going to be on December 14th. And I believe you're going to do, 9 to noon, Basil, and then 1 to 4, right?
That's a webinar coming up, but actually what I'm doing a week from tonight is I'm doing a webinar for subscribers. The second one is going to be an all-day webinar, but the one for subscribers comes up in another week, an hour and a half, 5 o'clock, next Tuesday night.
Yeah, you stay right there, folks. We're going to take a short break. And as you're at TFNN, you're going to go right into featured content. We're going to talk about this new webinar that Basil is doing a week from tonight first. Come right back, folks.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at tfnn.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Got our man, Mr. Basil Chapman. We are talking markets. And as you come over to our website at TFNN, folks, what you're going to see right in the front page, you're going to see featured content. Our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, is going to be doing a subscriber event. This is a week from today. And what this is going to be all about is what's next in the marketplace, live with Mr. Basil Chapman. He's going to be talking about after the October 4th sell signal in the Chapman wave, what is next for the market, what sectors are likely to rally, and which needs more time. Now, the way these subscriber events work, folks, is this. You can come to the event, you can come over, check out Basil's newsletter. As you hit that, you're going to see subscribe. Basil's newsletter is either a month, 6 months, a year, all have a 30-day money-back guarantee. So the bottom line, you have nothing to lose, everything to gain. You get the newsletter, you get a 30-day money-back guarantee. You can be into the workshop next Tuesday night from 5 to 6:30. So what are we going to be talking there, Basil?
So there are a couple of things that are really important. First of all, for about, it must be quite a few months now, I've been talking about when people called in, we're looking at the market, I said, this is not a bad time to be raising cash because there are going to be many sectors that come down sharply, and the sectors that lasted the longest on the upside are probably going to take the deepest hit and probably last quite a while in their retracements. You saw that Amazon has been pulling back very sharply, Google, Apple, you know, the FANG stocks have really been taken to the cleaners for the very first time in this period. So that says to me that maybe now you've got to be a lot more selective about that particular group because other things are going on. These are world events, for instance, Apple, we don't know what's going on with taxes, et cetera. So maybe now it's time to be looking at other sectors as well as other specific stocks. So that's what we'll be looking for, number one. Number two is looking at the potential for the next series of indications that say this is the sector that's starting to show good relative strength as the market's been pulling back. It's had its decline, it's had its time, it's had its price. Now it's probably ready for at least an attempt to move higher. So what we do very often, and if anyone remembers back in April when I did my webinar, that's when we went long the dollar. So there are many situations where we start preparing for something that might turn out, you never know, but it might turn out to be a daily buy signal that goes to a weekly, and now we've got a monthly buy signal in the dollar. So that's how I'm going to be looking at it. The other thing is, when you look at, just to take the Dow, for instance, you can see in this middle chart, the high of January was at 26,616, and it drops about 2,500 points, and then it has that big rally, and it goes from 23,360, it makes an arch formation, comes back and retests the 23,344 level, then it starts a bigger move, makes a nominal new high at 26,951. And what is the distance? What is the price that has declined? It's gone $2,829 to the downside, close to where it was. And now we have to say, okay, is this a series of higher highs and higher lows? What I'll be saying, we'll be going and looking at, because we'll have monthly candles to start comparing exactly what's going on, we'll be able to say the Dow, these are the specific levels to watch. If it goes under that, that's very bad. If it holds it, that's good. And on the upside, if it breaks to the upside, that's a very significant break. And we'll be going through the Dow, the S&P, the QQQ, the Index 100, the IWM. We'll be going through the different sectors as well. XLK, that's the tech sector. And most importantly, the semiconductor sector, and saying, where will they be ready? And of course, you spoke about the financials. The financials have just not been doing very well. My question will be, and we'll try to answer that, are they going to be part of this next big move to the upside when it occurs? And my suspicion is that the financials really need to be, otherwise it's not going to be all that successful. So it's very specific in saying, these are the levels to watch. This is where we've come. Now we can start slowly putting some cash back to work. Might maybe start small positions, then add at certain points. So it's very, very specific, and I think it's very timely because we've already had a pretty significant pullback. Now we're looking at this. If you look at the daily chart, you see this H pattern, this arch formation, could have another little arch formation and then do some retesting. So this is very important time-wise. And we will, because it's the first week of December, we'll have the November candles all done. And
which is pretty cool, right?
I mean, if you look at the QQQ, QQQ 1, 2, 3, there it is. Look at this monthly candle. This is the second big red candle. Now, we know that very often the last week of a month, actually the last few days of a month, you can get a fabulous rally. And of course, you've got the G20 negotiations. You've got a lot going on this weekend. So the candle close on Monday is going to be really important to be able to assess parameters for the coming 2 months to 3 months and exactly what levels to watch for support.
Yeah, and I'm sure there's plenty of traders looking for Santa Claus, right?
Well, that's the tradition. Now, we've done some things that are kind of untraditional so far this year. Didn't even get that Thanksgiving rally. We'll see what happens. But, yeah, we are oversold. And, yep, there could be a little bounce. But I think when you look at, you know, Amazon takes in from every source, Amazon, and look at the Amazon chart, 2050.50, all-time high back in September, and it goes down to just a few days ago, the 1400 level. Yeah, that's a lot of work to be done, and that's telling us, together with the RTH, which is the retail index, or you can go to the RTH. Look, the RTH also all the way from the, and look at the short period of time. It goes from the 112, I think that was 112, yeah, high of October the 1st, and now we're down at 100. These are big numbers for something like a retail sector.
Yes.
So this is going to be very important. Ready to be closed. I think we are oversold. Any excuse to have a bounce is right there. We're ready for something like that. What happens to the close on Monday, and how do we assess it, and what do we look at for the rest of the period going through December into January and starting the new year? It's going to be really important. Well, and there are some sectors. Yep, sorry.
No, you know what's interesting is that I was reading that story about the 9 million fewer shoppers. You know what I mean? That's a big number, man. I mean, and I don't know, you know, like I didn't do it because it seems like you don't always can get a deal. So it's like, okay, it just didn't even jump on. So I'm one of those 9 million because I know I did it. I think I did it last year. I'm not sure.
I was just looking. You're right. And here's the other thing. This is the first time that Amazon has actually had competition, because we've heard that Macy's, everyone, in fact, most of the big retailers have really developed a much better rapport in their online customer service.
I'd agree.
And I think that's going to make a little bit of a difference. I suspect that Amazon's going to come out with really good numbers, but nothing like it was. And that's going to set the stage for maybe the retailers will benefit a little bit. Yeah, you don't really want to see the brick and mortar buildings go out.
No,
I mean,
you
are we going to do?
You don't.
Turn them all into salons or something. I don't know what you're going to do with those buildings, but you need them.
Yeah, and no, you do. And I can see that, because I think we're all getting used to, like, just when you just mentioned Macy's, I was on Macy's site. I didn't order anything, but I was on Macy's site. I was on Walmart's site. So I did go to those sites, didn't order anything, but.
So you were what we used to call it, window shopping. I don't know what you call it, internet shopping.
Totally. At Filene's basement in Jordan Marsh.
That's exactly right.
Totally. Listen, folks, come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right under featured content. You can check out the opening call. 30-day money-back guarantee. You get in the workshop next Tuesday night. Basil, have a great one, safe one. We look forward to the program tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Tom.
Thank you.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked, money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of tfnn.com, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now at 83. You get the NASDAQ up 9. NASDAQ is down 3. S&Ps are up 10. So you're getting a little juice as we come into the close here, but you're not going to have the volume, folks. We go take a look at the SPYs. You're at 57 million. Yesterday, you were at 79. This is going to be a classic, how this thing baby shakes out. What we do have is that we are also coming into the end of the month. So when you start lining this baby up, so picture, we're Tuesday, all would have to happen, you get another little market going higher Wednesday, that is set up that you get probability the market is higher the rest of the week. Then what we have, of course, is that the end of the month is this coming Monday, window dressing is in spades, you got Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of next week, that gets window dressing going, and then guess what? Then, more than likely, if we look at these Qs, I suspect that the Qs get 32 million shares. Yesterday was 42. It might get up to 42, but bottom line, you can see, you know, you're coming into just nasty numbers, man. You're coming into 73 on the way down, 67 on the way down, 111 on the way down, 143 on the way down. Different ball game altogether, supply versus demand. That being said, I suspect that the Qs are still going to be able to get up to this 167. And where I'm going with the 167, in fact, where I'm going with all the indices, folks, if you're benchmarking this, October 11th is the day you want to look at. In the last time that we did this counter trend bounce, we got all the way up to 175. Now, that was going against the October 10th high volume day. The reason I'm picking this October 11th, it's just a high volume spike on the way down. Bottom line is that what normally happens is this. The first counter trend bounce that we did in the S&P, monster bounce. It was a 0.618 bounce of the whole deal. Now, that 0.618 bounce is actually saying that you have a strong market. Inside the Qs, we almost also did a 0.618 bounce. So what you have, the way this sets up, is that if we're going to go lower, most times you're not going to have the same type of bounce. It should get weaker as it tends to get higher. And in fact, if I put this, I just want to see where we're setting up this way. So right now, yeah, if we did a 50% bounce from the last swing high, that's 166.90, and I'm looking for 167.81. So it's right in between. I'm looking for between a 50 to 0.618 retracement. I'm not looking for the full 0.618 this time. Now, if that's what we get, too, that also is a good counter trend bounce. So we'll see where it shakes out. Time-wise, this is setting up kind of how if you're on the bearish side and you think you are going south, that basically is setting up pretty well. Because of the fact that would be at the end of the first week of December, you have 2 weeks of trading before we're into holiday trading in a big way. I'm going to look at this for a second. I just want to look at my calendar for a second because what we want to see is the aspect. Let me just see this. I want to see what Christmas is on so we get an idea. Okay, so Christmas is on a Tuesday this year. New Year's is going to be on a Tuesday. So a couple of different things end up happening, actually. That means that we're actually going to have 3 full weeks of pretty good trading because of the fact that Christmas is on a Tuesday. So, yeah, that Friday before, but there'll be 3 good weeks of trading, you know, which most times in December you get about 2.5 weeks. The reason you'd have that is that it's basically pushing off Tuesday to the last week of the month, and then what you'll end up having there is that it'll be the, you know, it'll be the full week of Christmas, and of course going into New Year's, and then a couple of days after New Year's, and that's when you start getting some action once again inside the marketplace. But there's plenty of time there to get a sell down actually going, particularly in the type of environment that we're in right now with the amount of tafts that are going to be taking place. Because we got to remember, as we're going to be kicking into the new year, that's when a lot of these tafts are going to be kicking in also. You know, bottom line, you know, Apple bottom line is at 174. We'll end up getting the numbers on Apple as well as, you know, what kind of tafts are coming into place. And when you're taking a look at Apple, as I met Mr. Basil Chapman, when he was just talking about these monthly candles, this is about as nasty as you can get when you're taking a look at if you get into candlestick charting, when you take a look at Apple, I'll put it up on this one instead of a bar chart. You're going to see, we bring this back, and I put this on a monthly. This is one nasty candle. And this is something to keep in mind. Most times when you get something that's this large, meaning that you go from $222 down to $170 nonstop, you don't get one of these. These things normally don't come in ones. That's because the sell-off is so dramatic. You know, we'll see whether, you know, you get, well, we'll find out whether you get 2 or 3 of these at the same time. If we, you know, the a classic, if this is going to be a real humdinger of a correction, would be 3 black crows. 3 black crows. What happens with 3 black crows, folks, is that you go down, simultaneously approximately the same amount of price 3 separate times in a row. Meaning, I can't picture Apple doing that on a monthly, but you can picture them doing it on the weeklies, that's for sure. And if that's what we get, that is a sign that this correction is going to be long and much longer than we actually expected this time. The way where I'm coming from at this particular time is that if I bring up this S&P the whole way, I suspect at this particular point is that you have the bottom of the consolidation is going to be the high volume low, 2532. And then top of it is up there at 2940. So you're talking about 400 points in the S&P, 4,000 points in the Dow. We break that with volume, and then guess what, man? If we break that with volume, there's going to be big problems because this will be down into the 2100 number in about a heartbeat. You know, so you're talking serious business because that would be like a 33% correction. And we haven't had anything like that in a long period of time, particularly in the S&P. We have plenty of equities that have come back that far. But with the whole indice, different ballgame. You know, because mostly what ends up happening, and that's why that high volume low inside the S&P February low, I suspect this point is going to hold because you'll get a rotation. You know, because what ends up happening is that as equities go lower, there's some equities that will make money. In fact, they make better money in environments that actually go lower. That's how I don't know if they make better money. What ends up happening, money will shift into those equities as they're going lower, as defensive plays. That's how that shakes out. I mean, you know, Verizon, you know, bottom line is that you can look at Verizon. Verizon's almost at all-time highs. You know, Verizon makes a fortune. That's not going to change. The revenue, you know, talking about $132 billion, forget it, man. You know, that's where people will start pushing it into. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. We have the Dow Industrials up 100, NASDAQ is flat, S&P's up 11. Come right back.
I'm certain you. are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 81. We get the NASDAQ flat. S&Ps are up 10. Let's go over to that composite and take a look at the composite. Yeah, you get a sideways move, okay? We got to a high. The composite hit 71.05 today. High out there yesterday was 70.83. If we do take a look at the volume inside the indices out here, inside the NYSE, so you're at 542. We did 882 yesterday. So they'll throw 200 or 300 into this. But that even at 300, that's going to be lighter volume. That'll be 842, if that's what we get. We'll find out within the next 10 minutes for sure. We go into the NASDAQ composite. Composite might do more. We did $2 billion yesterday, 1.78 right now we are at. And, we'll see what they end up throwing into the composite. What we do have is that when we take a look at this, you can see if we pull this back up. Let me see. I want to see exactly what we're going into. So this is a monster we're going into. Yeah, we're going into the 19th. So the 19th did $2.35 billion. And we're going to do a lot less than that. That's when I say what we're going into, specifically meaning that, okay, so you're coming back topside. You know, you're coming into that downdraft from the 19th, and that's where we did $2.5 billion. So bottom line, it's going to be up market, volume contracting, also volume contracting inside of the ETF structures in a large way. If we go over to those, let's go just look at the IWM for a second. Yeah, IWM, 12 million shares yesterday. It did 12.7 million yesterday. It's almost going to be the same. NDX 100, that's going to have a contraction. 34 million yesterday. We banged out 42. And the SPY, looks like the SPY is going to be the largest one, unless you get a couple of big monsters coming in at the close. They might get it up there. 79 we did yesterday. We're at 62 right now. Stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back with some numbers after the close. We have the Dow Industrials up 96. NASDAQ down 2. S&P's up 11. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN Headline News Update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 108. You had the NASDAQ flat, S&P's up 11. Bottom line, folks, is that you get a market that is going higher. You have volume contracting as we get to higher price. We take a look at the S&P. You get the 70 million shares in the SPY. Yesterday, you did 79. You know, that being said, you're going into 146. You're going into 274 million. Big numbers. We take a look at the NDX 100, the 3Qs. Same type of setup inside the 3Qs. That's done 35 million today. Yesterday we did 42. That baby is coming into 75 million. You're coming into 102 million. You're coming into 143 million. So you can see you get a counter trend bounce going. You are coming up with volume contract, and I expect that we still are going to actually go higher. Gold contract. Gold contract are down $8.20, trading at $12.14 an ounce. Let's go take a look at that gold contract. What we have with gold is this. Gold contract come down 285,000 contract. Contracts traded. 12.17 was the number. Intraday, folks, that's when the volume stopped. That being said, guess what? It would have to get over, or it had to reject the 12.17 price point, and it did not do that. So that does set up that this gold contract can test the 11.96 area now. Notes and bonds continue to want higher price. You talk about divergence. And they both had monster volume, folks, okay? We're talking about big volume. We're talking about 3 million contracts inside the 10-year. You know, the volume started as I was closing the show yesterday. It was monster volume yesterday. We did 2.5 million contracts yesterday, 3 million today. You're over the swing point of 119.06. We're trading 119.07. Guess what? That sets up the highs of August 22nd, which is 120.20. 30-year bonds, same type of setup inside the 30-year. Also had monster volume, buying it hand over fist. We go take a look at this 30, what you're going to see inside the 30. 30, USC, 8. USZ. Sorry about this, folks. Where is it coming? Just disappeared on me. Bottom line is that you do have volume inside the 30 also. They both want higher price. Stay right there, folks. Come back with some numbers after the close. To recap, we had the Dow Industrials up 108, NASDAQ flat, S&P's up 12. Come right back.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked, money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every phone calls, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look, oh, it's a beautiful thing. Got our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We gonna take it by storm?
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Accept others the way they are. You cannot change other people. Trying to change them to fit what you want them to be is like trying to change a dog into a cat. A cat and a horse. They are what they are, and you are what you are. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 108. NASDAQ was flat. S&P's up 11.5. Gold contract down $8.20, trading at $12.14 an ounce. Silver down 11 cents, $14.09 an ounce. Light sweet crude also flat, $51.78 a barrel. Light sweet crude, folks, that baby is building cars to get down to the 45 level. So we're talking about, we've already had some heavy destruction. We've gone from 76 down to 51 since October 2nd. Bottom line, looks to me like we're going lower. Notes and bonds, higher price, lower yield. You get the 10-year note, up three ticks, 119.07. 30-year bond up five, trading 139.30. Now, in both cases, folks, monster volume. They took out their swings, took them out with volume. They both want higher price, lower yield. And when we're talking higher price out here, you get the 10-year yield right now is at 3.05. If we actually go take a look at how this 10-year is trading, and this is where it's going to get really wild, is that we did 3 million contracts inside the 10-year today. That's huge contract volume. You're over the swing point. We're over the swing point of 119.06. We're at 19.07. That sets up a run to 120.20. And 120.20 was the high, last swing high, August 22nd. What that will do, that'll bring that 10-year right back under 3%. And that's what we get, I think that's going to be shocking for the marketplace. And what it's also going to be saying is that that S&P is going to be running into lower price. If that's what we actually have playing out here. The 30-year. Monster volume in the 30-year. You know, this started yesterday when I was on the air, and it's pretty amazing, you know, the type of acceleration that they're buying. We've done 683,000 contracts in the 30-year. Yesterday, you did 662,000. Your swing point that it was taken out was 553, so that just blew it away. That sets up 30-year to go after 145.16. 155.06 rather, which also was the high that was generated out here in August. Now, what I want to do is this. We're going to put a continuous contract up. Because the ironic part about the bond market in general is this. The bond market has been in a bear market since 1980. And when you actually take a look at this, your uptrend is still not broken. This is the thing that's a mind blower, that when we actually pull this up. Because for the trend to be broken, that we believe it did this before, it has to get down to, we made it down to a price point of 136. And in order for that to be broken, you got to get down to 123. in order for that uptrend to be broken. Let me see if I can get it back even further. So that's 50 years. Let's do a yearly. Yeah, no, 50 years. That's, I know that sounds bizarre, but bottom line is that what we did do, you know, in 1998, you know, you went from 135, bottom line almost broke it, but didn't. Went down to 89. And then just took off like a rocket ship again. It took years in order to repair that, but bottom line, that trend is still in place. And the trend we're talking about started in September of 1981. That's when the price of the bonds were $55, or $550 for a $1,000 bond that was paying 14.5% interest. How's that, right? That's pretty intense. And what they, you know, it, depending on how long you've been in the marketplace, folks, some of you younger folks, you won't remember this, but this was really cool because in the 80s, in the 70s, bottom line is that you actually had bearer bonds. And bearer bonds was something else. Bearer bonds, you know, were basically you buy a bond, you could go right into the banks at that point, buy the bonds. Bottom line, whoever had the bonds had the money. That's how non-transparent the bond market was. And that's one of the main reasons for that when the U.S. put those in place was that they could shake money out of the citizens of the U.S. and they knew that it was going to be basically, you know, money that who knows where it come from. They didn't care at that particular point because guess what? The government had to get financed. So bearer bonds were a big deal for years. I don't know what year they started, but you're talking about, well, I'll actually pull it up at the break. I suspect that started in the 20s, 1920s or something like that. They did get rid of them because the bottom line is that was always a great way to launder money, period. There's no doubt about it. You know, there's plenty of old movies that you see with the bearer bonds inside suitcases showing up at airports. Some of the higher volume equities out here today, you had General Electric, that's still in trouble, that's down 14 cents. Marbell was up 49 cents. Phone company's got some juice in them today. General Motors is down 96 cents. U.S. Steel's taking it on the chin. That was down $2. U.S. Steel broke lows, monster volume on the break lower. We take a look at this on a weekly basis. Yeah, you got an ABC down. It's a big one, too. 8 point on is 38. Your B is 24. Holy cow, $14. So that gives you about a $14 A to B, you'll see to D, and your last swing low out here is $18.55. That is from May of 2017. We'll put this on a monthly. Yeah, this is toast. Back down to 14. You get a swing point at 18. That's where this looks like it's going to basically lay out. And if you do look at U.S. Steel over a long period of time, bottom line is that was a stock that was $196 in 2008. Never recuperated. Why? Because guess what? They got old plants, and what this run coming downtown today is all about, folks, is that you get Steel Dynamics, STDL. What they have done is that they, STLD, it must be STLD, they announced that they're building a $1.5 billion new plant. And I just went to all-time lows also because the market didn't like it. And that new plant's going to be up and running in a few years. And what that will do, of course, new technology, you know, new plant, bottom line, they're going to be efficient, and that's going to put more supply on the marketplace. So all the steel stocks get hit. Dow Industrials up 108, NASDAQ flat, S&P's up 13. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hey folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. Dow Industrials finished up 108. We had the NASDAQ flat. S&P's up 13. And if we do go over, and let's go take a look at all these volumes. Then 15 minutes after the close here. So 73 million inside the SPY. Yesterday had 79. So you get the contraction of volume. And the contraction of volume, by the way, it goes like this, folks. It goes the aspect that we come down in volume, you're going up on lighter volume, and it's going to be the volume that you're going against. What does happen, and that's why I thought there was going to be lighter volume today, is that when you do get a counter trend bounce like this, most times the second day of the counter trend bounce, it contracts pretty good. You know, now, if we get a contraction tomorrow and the next day, too, that's a big heads up. You know, when you're running like 73 million, yeah, it'll be light volume. And most of the time, we'll stay at the 73, 75 million if that's what we've been doing. We go inside the NDX 100. We take a look at the Qs. Qs also came in with lighter volume. Yesterday, we did 42 million, 36 today. Now, that's a big differential. That's 7 million shares. Differential when, in fact, you're going into 63 million, you're going into 111 million, you're going into 143 million. So you're talking about big numbers there. We take a look at the SPY, the IWM. IWM actually just went sideways today, didn't make another high. So IWM did 14.2 million, yesterday did 15.3. The indice volume, we take a look at the indice volume out here. What we did with the indices, you did 831 million inside the NYSE versus 882 yesterday. And we go into the NASDAQ composite. Inside the composite, we did 2.047 billion. We did 2 billion yesterday. So it's two against two. Bottom line, that is setting up lower prices. That's how this baby shakes. The XLF, which has not been able to get any traction whatsoever, still can't get the traction. You're up 2 cents. You're trading at 26.55. We did 46 million. Yesterday, you did 50. You can see it's right across the board what we have happening out here in the context of how you're getting to higher price. This market has
Well, let's go into the Dow. This market's going to have a huge amount of repairing to do. And I just don't see it before we actually get into 2019. The reason being is that we take a look at the Dow. So we pull up the Dow Industrials. What you're going to see in the Dow is this. We bring this baby back. What the Dow hasn't done yet is got to the bottom of the consolidation where I figure we're going to go. 23,360. Now, that's only 1,300 bucks from where we are. You know, last week we got to 24,268. Yet the week of November 2nd, we got down to 24,122. This just looks to me like just a monster consolidation that's going to be in here for quite some time. And it better hold, because if you don't hold the bottom of that consolidation, there's nothing stopping this thing, because we went up so dramatically. Because we went up so dramatically from January of 2017 straight up to January of 2018, you break that consolidation, you can down just as quick. That's how this shakes out. You know, at this particular point, it looks like to me that it's just going to basically test that level. We'll see what kind of volume we have on the test on the way down. We can go from there. If we go take a look at some of the GDX inside the gold market, GDX out here today had 50 million shares traded. That's going into 66. So we did get volume inside the GDX out here. That is basically setting up. You know, the GDX is trading $18.87. That would be setting up that we can get down to the lower end of the swing point again, which is 18.26. Now, that being said, we are coming into where we had the big strength also. The big strength was 134 million. That price point is $18.71. So you can see we're at 18.87. And they hit, you know, if we look at this gold contract, they start hitting gold early. And it wasn't even that the dollar index basically had already got into the 300 uptick. When Tommy and I were on the air this morning, that's when it really started getting hit, 10 o'clock, right in the nose. We went from 1221, that was the first sell, 8,900 contracts. Second sell came in, got it down to 1215 with 11,000 contracts. The cool thing here is this, is that that's the last time we had any volume on the way down. You know, they got it to lower price, but guess what? Sellers were done at 1217. Now, 1217 is important. The reason that's so important is that 1217 is the high of how we come off the last low. 1217.20 is the exact number actually on this contract. You know, it looks to me like, yeah, we're probably going to get into it. And I suspect what we're going to have there is that what this is going to be all about, the dollar finished at its high today, up 300 ticks. No volume behind the move, 19,000 contracts. That's after coming down with 34,000 contracts, 37,000 contracts, 29,000 contracts. Monster numbers coming off those highs. But that being said, this wants to go basically visit its friends up at 97,530. That's the way this seems to be shaking out. What was pretty interesting, and I brought this up in the first hour, was the aspect that the number of shoppers were 9 million less. 9 million. That is a big number, folks, over the course of this, you know, the whole cyber trading, Black Friday, First Friday, the whole ball of wax. You know, so we'll see what kind of numbers all these retailers actually come in with, you know. People are spending money, there's no doubt about that. But, you know, when I was talking to Mr. Basil Chapman in the first hour, we were really talking about the aspect that, I was talking about the aspect that it seems like there's always so many deals out there now. None of these special days seem to be special anymore. So it's like, if you need something, you get on, you hunt something for a while, you figure it out, okay, is it a deal, isn't it a deal? And I think that's why there's probably 9 million less people that were actually shopping out there on, you know, this whole Thanksgiving deal. Certainly, Amazon, bottom line, you know, 5.7 million shares today. That was going into 6.2. You know, so you can see Amazon's bouncing on light volume, too. And if we bring this back, you know, Amazon doesn't look to me like it's done either. You know, you're down from 2050 or 1581, you get about 25% flow on the way down. And all these numbers, when we, kind of went south here, there's no doubt that this thing was fast and furious as we were going south. And yeah, the market, so picture this. This is where this always gets confusion when people get their statements at the end of the month. So the Dow Jones is up for the year 1%. S&Ps are up 1.2. NASDAQ is up 3.5. I don't know what the exact number is, but I can guarantee you, well, I can't guarantee anything, but bottom line is that people are going to be surprised when they open up their portfolios and they're down 10, 12%. You know, so how does that happen? Okay, we shouldn't be down that much. Well, when you take a look at some of these equities, a lot of these equities, a lot of high-flying equities are down 25%. So they're going to have some of those high-flying equities inside their portfolios. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow finished up 108. NASDAQ flat. S&P's up 13. We'll come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished up 108, NASDAQ flat, S&P's up 14. And we go over and we take a look at the Walmart out here, folks. Flat market out here today with Walmart. And what's going to be intriguing is that, you know, we're going to be getting the numbers the next few days about exactly the amount that was bought you know, over the last few days, because that comes in pretty quick with the amount of credit cards that we basically, that's all we kind of use right now. And, you know, we'll see what these numbers come out like. You know, 9 million less shoppers. They know at this point there's 9 million less shoppers, but maybe we'll actually have this thing come out tonight. Because if they already know the number of shoppers, I suspect they're getting close to getting the amount of numbers. Because I believe that they take the numbers from the Friday or the Wednesday, maybe at Thanksgiving. I know at least the Friday until last night at midnight. That's what they're looking for all the deals. If we take a look at Walmart, you're going to see Walmart had that high out here of $109. That was in February. You know, goes up to a 106, kind of just laying at that level. If we go over to Macy's, we take a look at Macy's. Macy's, the low for the year is 20, the high is 41. This has come down, you know, when the market was coming down, no doubt about that. It's going to be intriguing to see what these other companies can do. You know, Macy's is down from $73. That was in the 2015. But we'll see whether they, you know, they get any juice, because when I actually do look at Macy's on a monthly, this is actually setting up pretty good. This is going to be intriguing watching this. So this is what you have. Macy's this month is pushing 188 million shares, is going into 186, and we still, you know, bottom line, you're not at the end of the month. So you're actually starting to push into the swings with volume. Yeah, we'll see. It's real possible that what we may have out here is that these folks that actually stayed alive, meaning the retailers that stayed alive, they got the internet up and going as well as they can. And bottom line is that, you know, we're shopping more than just at Amazon. Crude oil. Let's go take a look at crude oil. Crude oil numbers just come out. So crude stocks rose 3.4 million barrels out here last week. That's not a big number. So that'll put a little juice inside the oil market. Right now it's put a few pennies inside it, nothing heavy. Oil closed out here today at $51. It's interesting, man. Yeah, they're having a hard time getting quotes up here. This has happened to me earlier too. CLF9. Okay, so crude, they probably just took it away because of the, no, they don't do that. So okay, so crude right now, 52.38. And if we do go take a look at the continuous contract, what you're gonna see with the continuous contract on crude is that it's broken down. Come on. Okay, so yeah, you broke into this consolidation pretty heavily. So the top of the consolidation was $55. And that's setting up the 45. That's where this is coming from. You know, we went straight down. In fact, what's going to be interesting in the crude market is this, is looking at the aspect of, I was talking about a little bit earlier about the S&P. So the S&P, Apple. Let's talk about Apple. Apple's candle this month is going to be vicious, okay? It's a huge, for 1 month, this is a monster. When you're talking about November has not been a kind month to Apple. If we take a look at this, I'll just go over the number again. So Apple in the month of November has gone from $222 to $170. We take a look at the crude, and you get 2 months. $76 to $64 was October. Thus far in November, $65 to $50. Now, when you get two of them, folks, guess what? These like coming in threes. And that's going to be crazy if that's what you get, because, you know, now you're talking about $45. There's the swing low out here is actually 39. You know, the first swing low is 42. So we're talking about some big numbers. If we go over to the gasoline market, which we all use every day, we take a look at gasoline. Gasoline out here, wholesale right now is $1.42 and XB1. If we see where this baby's going, This has been a one-way route on the way down. October 2nd was 215. We're at 142. We pull this back. Yeah, this is game like the. This is a game to 126. The top of. Once we broke into 166 in the unleaded market, that sets up the other side of that consolidation, which is 126. So that's pretty intense. That when you get that heavy. Okay, so let's see what I know what we want to do. Let's go to XBT. So crypto, Bitcoin. Bitcoin's 37.27 right now. It's up $63. Let's see what Goldman is saying about crypto right now. Goldman Sachs isn't any closer to offering one of the key services sought by clients still intrigued by cryptocurrencies among this year's collapse. One of the things they asked me, can you hold our coins? And I say, no, we cannot. The bank's head of digital asset markets said during a conference in New York. One of the things we have to take into consideration when we're building our business is that what we can and cannot do in a regulatory perspective. Goldman has been among the major Wall Street banks using alternative methods such as investing last month in custodial service provider BitGo Holdings to wade into the sector. It is also among the first to clear Bitcoin futures offered by the CBOE Global Markets and the CME. The company was considering whether to start a trading desk to make markets in the digital currencies Bloomberg had reported last year. But from a regulatory perspective, there are things that are more limited in terms of what we can offer, Schmidt said during a panel presentation. This is today at the CoinDesk Census Investment Conference, adding that clients are quite curious about the space and price changes and how we keep assets safe. Bitcoin, the largest crypto, has plunged, dropping more than 40% in November. Progress has been made in the crypto space, Schmidt said, citing Bankit's future exchange and Fidelity's jump into the crypto area. With new business to manage digital assets for hedge funds, family offices, and trading firms. However, institutional investors tend to be conservative and more progress has to be made at the custodial level. Custodial is the foundation piece that is absolutely necessary. That's there's no doubt about that, man. It's like the whole thing about Bitcoin, right, is that you get a coin, if it's not in your wallet, you don't want to lose your wallet, you lose everything. Bottom line is that the custodial deal of these and the amount of times that they've been hacked is pretty incredible. What's going to get intriguing here is that as we look at Bitcoin, you know, is Bitcoin going to get into the 1200 area? Right now you're at 27 to 23. There's not much support here. That's the real bottom line. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion.
While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Let's go take a look at Salesforce out here. Salesforce, folks, low for the year is $98, high is 161, it closed at 127. Right now we are trading at 135. That's quite a little pop on Salesforce, so let's see what they have to say. So 135, yeah, brings it back a couple weeks. So let's see what they have to say out here, number-wise. Their estimate was 50 cents. They came in with 61. That's a big number. That's bottom line number, sales, earnings per share. Revenue number, $3.37 billion was the estimate. They came in with $3.39 billion. So bottom line is that they got it both ways, no doubt. Full year revenue forecast. Oh, that's interesting. No, oh, that meets estimates. Okay, I thought it said it was going to... Okay, so here's the numbers. They see fiscal year revenue. They had seen it at $13.13 billion to $13.18. They actually see it bigger than that, $13.23 billion now to $13.24. So bottom line is it is over that estimate. Fourth quarter revenue, they had estimated at $3.53 billion. They are going to be basically doing $3.55 to $3.56. Their adjusted the third quarter revenue, that's what they just reported. They actually blew away the third quarter revenue in a big way. The estimate was 50 cents. They made 61. So bottom line, decent numbers inside of Salesforce. And they get quite a business plan, there's no doubt. You know, it's the whole cloud structure. They've been into the cloud structure way before everyone else was into the cloud structure. You know, this equity, we go bring it back. Well, you can bring it back to 2000, let's see, just the run of 2017, $69, up to this 160 level. And, you know, you pull back, but they pull back with volume, though. There's no doubt about that. Those babies have pulled back with volume. Let's see with this one. This is, here's an Argentina stock. This is going to be interesting. Let's see what happened with this one. No, actually, T-E-N-I-M. Okay, so, oh, this is an Italian stock. Oh, this thing is busted apart. Well, here, let me see after the close. No, wasn't that bad. Wasn't that bad. Oh, I see. Yeah, no, it's gone down for quite some time. No doubt about it. No doubt about that. We, CRM. So revenue-wise, let's see where the growth aspects come from. So revenue-wise, man, this is pretty amazing, actually. So they've gone from $4.1 billion in 2014 all the way up to $13.2 billion. That's a monster move, man. Huge. Let's go to Marty in Maryland. Hey, Marty, what's going on?
Tom, it's been 7 years.
7 years. Well, yes, it's. I appreciate you calling, man. How you been?
Doing great. Doing great. Became a widower in that time, but
I'm sorry, man. Sorry about that. That's terrible.
Yeah. Anyway, Tom, how are we looking for Pretium Gold and Silvercrest?
Okay, so let's take a look at this. The first one is Pretium Resources. They acquire, explore, develop precious metals in northern British Columbia, Canada. Okay, so they're taking in $481 million, so they're a producer. Okay, cool. The low's 617, the high's 1190. So now, do you own this? You're looking to buy it here.
I've owned it, Tom, since $2.82, but I've traded it the last four years anyway.
Okay, cool. Okay, so let's see. So January 2018, it had quite a hit. What happened there? That's what it's trying to get through now, I guess. That's, you know.
Well, there was a lot of short. The shorts just came in. That thing's been running 10% short for the last 3-4 years.
Okay.
But they knocked it down, 45% there, and for really no good reason.
Okay. So this is what's going to make it through. You know, that's what it's still trying to get through. Now, it's just start digging into it. You know, if you happen to be watching Tiger's TV, you can see the top of that bar is 1190, the bottom 676. When we go back to September, I like what's happening there. You know, September was pushing with volume, not so much last month. This month is backing down with light volume, which that's how you want it, you know.
Exactly.
You know, so that's what it's trying to do, man. You know, now, normally what ends up happening, Marty, is that if this comes in, like, I take the bottom of that bar, which is 676, the top is 11, so you get $5, right? If you can get into that by a couple dollars, then you got a real shot that it's going to go to the top of that. That's kind of how that shakes out. And then the second one you'd like to look at is SILV, right? Okay,
exactly.
Okay, so this is Silvercrest. The low is 86 cents. Excuse me, folks. The high is $3. It's an exploration company, Base Minerals, Mexico. This is still an exploration company. You get a market cap of $179 million. So tell me about these guys.
They spun off the San Dimas mine to First Majestic.
Okay.
And, Tom, everything they've touched has turned to gold, and this Las Chispas mine in the Sonora, Mexico, I mean, they're hitting bonanza-grade stuff every time they drill a hole.
That's pretty cool. Okay.
I got it at 11 cents when they did the spinoff. You know, they dropped down and went down to 11 cents after the spinoff.
Yeah.
Well, we actually got down, I think, to 8 cents.
I can see it. 8-9 cents, right. Yeah.
I've been trading this thing every time I make 50 cents, I'll sell 20%.
Yeah.
It's been terrific for me. But what are we looking at going forward?
No, that last month was a good month, man. That 307 is a high volume high right now. It was going into 312. So picture 312 had 985 million. Bottom line, 985,000. You went into a 2.4 million. That's a good setup, man. That'll be back up at 307. Yeah. So that's interesting.
One last thing, Tom. When's tax loss? When's this all come to an end as far as for the mining stocks?
This is a great question, folks, because what happens is this. This is not a United States deal, but it's a Canada deal. And I don't know the exact date, but that's what there's different rules up in Canada, folks, inside the aspect of how you're selling and tax loss in general. You know, I'll find out, Marty. I don't know the exact date, but we're in it right now, man. That's for sure.
Exactly.
That's the bottom line. Yeah. For sure. So.
Love you, brother.
Hey, listen, man, thanks so much for the call. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us. And I'm sorry about your wife, man. That's terrible. And, you know, the hottest thing is that it happens, you know, all the time. It's like, how does life work, right? I mean, that's what seems to be so hot. It's like, okay, how can we be here and then we're not here? And it doesn't even make any sense, right? It's like, it's always the question.
Exactly.
I know, man. Sorry, man. Well, listen, great hearing from you, man. You have a great one, a safe one, and call us again, all right?
Absolutely.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Well, Tiger Woods is back, folks. Let's see what he's going to be doing. Discovery is going to be doing a deal. Let's see. Tiger struck a deal with Discovery for a dedicated channel on its Netflix-like golf service. Armed with exclusive videos featuring the greatest golfer in a generation, Discovery is looking to drive more subscriptions to its Golf TV, a streaming video service that is going to start in January and is being developed by Discovery and the PGA Tour. Woods is going to prepare in a variety of programming for the services, including instructional videos, behind-the-scenes footage showing how he prepares for tournaments. The 42-year-old will get a cut of the subscription revenue from Golf TV, which will also broadcast live tournaments. While known for unscripted program like Shark Week, Discovery is focused on becoming a leader in global sports broadcasting. It acquired a trove of TV sports licenses, including European rights to the Olympics through 2024 for $1.14 billion. The deal is the latest sign that Tiger, one of the most guarded athletes in the world, is opening up more in the twilight of his career. On Woods Friday faced off against Phil Mickelson in a pay-per-view duel in which the players took the rare step of wearing microphones on course. Woods lost the match, and the event was marred by a technical glitch processing customer online payments, forcing distributors to make it free to watch. Oh, I didn't know that. Oh, that's crazy. Can you imagine? I didn't jump on that. I was doing something, but that is crazy. It was a paid online and it ended up being free to watch. Oh, my God. And they, you know, bottom line is that I know it went into overtime. And that would have been a big number, no doubt. Well, the number of Americans playing golf has been declining. Woods remains a massive TV ratings draw after returning to the tour the past year. There's no doubt about it. The bottom line is that that's how they can sell golf clubs. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. We look forward to speaking with you right here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Real! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.